NFL fans, who is ready for the playoffs to get underway? I know I am. It'll be here next weekend. Like this video if you are fired up for the 2021 NFL playoffs. Sunday Night Football about to kick off if you're watching this right as it goes out. If not, the playoffs might be completely set. On today's video, we'll take a look at that NFC bracket as the NFC playoff picture is finalized. But like the video, and let's jump on in. What's going on, football fans? Harrison Graham here, NFL Daily by Chat Sports. Like I mentioned, the NFC playoff picture is set. It's finalized. Adios to the New Orleans Saints. They have been eliminated after an epic afternoon game between the 49ers and the Rams. We'll kind of talk about the key results that took place today and take a look at 1-7 in the NFC, which is where we'll take an early look here. Green Bay did play today. They lost. Didn't matter. They had already clinched the number one seed at 13-4. Tampa won today at 13-4. They're the 2 seed. Dallas, the 3 seed after their win on Saturday. They're 12-5. The Rams at 12-5, the 4 seed. Cardinals are the 5 seed at 11-6. The 49ers, after an epic win at 10-7, are the 6 seed. And then the Philadelphia Eagles at 9-8 are the 7 seed. And you guys see the matchup there on your screen. We'll break down each individual matchup later on in the show. Who will win the NFC and represent the NFC in the Super Bowl? Will it be those top-seeded Packers? Do you think it's going to be Tampa, Dallas, somebody else? Let us know in the comments. This will be the pinned comment on today's video, so if you get hit with the YouTube ad break, get your answer in, and after the ad break, we'll talk more about the NFC playoff picture. I think the NFC is wide open. I really, really do. Now, I do think it's a bit of a drop-off when you get to 6-7, San Francisco and Philadelphia, but I think those top five teams, especially the top four, could all conceivably represent the NFC in the Super Bowl this year. I think it's been one of those years where even Green Bay, while they've looked like the most consistent game, they've had a few games this year where it's like they don't look that good. Every team is vulnerable. Every team is talented. Every team is capable of making a run to the Super Bowl in the NFC. You take a look at some of the key matchups to determine these final seedings in the NFC based on what happened in Week 18. Dallas took care of business on Saturday in a 51-26 win over Philadelphia. Eagles kind of treated that as a preseason game since they had already clinched. Dallas was hoping they could move up, and they did. Tampa Bay hammers Carolina 41-17. The Seahawks upset the Cardinals 38-30. That locked Arizona into the 5 seed. The Saints lost or beat the Falcons to put pressure on the 49ers, and the 49ers erased a 17-0 deficit to beat the Rams 27-24. So they get in as the 6 seed. The Saints are eliminated despite a 9-8 season. Really good job by Sean Payton this year, but they are out of the NFC playoff picture. Let's talk about that number one seed, Green Bay Packers. They did play this week, lost 37-30 in Detroit. Starters played about a half. Aaron Rodgers played the first half. And then Matt LaFleur got his key guys out of there. They will, of course, have a first-round bye and home field advantage throughout the playoffs as long as they are still alive. So they'll get to sit back on the couch, pop up in a couple of cold ones, and see how these other games play out. And that's why getting that number one seed, especially now when only one team in each conference gets a first-round bye, is so critical. So for Green Bay to clinch that last week in Week 17, that was important. It allowed them to be flexible on how long they played guys this week. They took advantage of that, played their guys for about a half, and now they will get a week off. Are the Packers the best team in the NFC? Type Y for yes, type N for no. I think they are, but that doesn't mean that they're for sure going to represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. This defense is really good. You've got Aaron Rodgers, Aaron Jones, Devontae Adams. David Bakhtiari is back, by the way, as well. We saw him play today. Get your votes in. Are the Packers the best team in the NFC? Y for yes or N for no. Today's show is presented by BetUS, the best sportsbook partner on the internet. And if you want to go bet on some of these playoff matchups, there's only one place to do it. That's chatsports.com/bet. Use that promo code NFLDaily. That's NFLDaily, all one word, when you go to chatsports.com/bet. Put down $100, you get $125 for free. We've got some Super Bowl odds. Those Packers are the favorites at plus 375. So if you wanted to put $10 on them, if they end up winning it, you'd get $37.50 in winnings plus your initial $10 back. Chiefs at plus 450, Bucks at plus 700. You got the Bills and Rams in there as well. Chatsports.com/bet. promo code NFL Daily. It's all one word, NFL Daily, to get that 125% deposit bonus. All right, let's take a look at these NFL wildcard matchups for the NFC. Philadelphia, again, kind of just treated this weekend as a preseason game, sat Jalen Hurts and a lot of key players. They finished 9-8 on the year, had won four straight before that loss to Dallas. They'll get Tampa, who's 13-4. If you remember earlier this year, before Philadelphia started playing well, Eagles got hit in the mouth early by Tampa, but kind of rallied late to make that a football game. We'll see if resting the key players was a good move by Nick Sirianni. Obviously, Tampa Bay is going to be a heavy favorite in this one. By the way, once we know the dates and the times of these games are finalized, we will put a comment in the video and also update the description of this video. We don't know as we're filming this what the times of these games are going to kick off at. We do know, of course, it'll be in Tampa, Florida. Who you got in this matchup? Type TB for Tampa Bay. Type PHI for the Philadelphia Eagles. Get your votes in down in the comment section. Who you riding with in this matchup? Obviously, the Bucs are going to be a pretty heavy favorite here, but weird things have happened. Let us know what you guys think. All right, this is taking it back to the 90s. Brett Scott is getting nervous about this Niners-Cowboys game because there were some tough ones for the Cowboys against San Francisco back in the day. This will be a classic one. I expect this one to be one of the primetime games, whether it's Saturday night or Sunday late afternoon. We'll see. San Francisco, like we mentioned, had that epic win over Los Angeles. The Cowboys took care of business against Philadelphia. This is the 3-6 matchup in the NFC playoff picture. We'll see what happens here. I'm very fascinated to see how this game plays out. These two teams have not played each other this year, so it should be a good matchup at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Again, once we know the times and dates of all these games, we will put that information down in the comments and in the description. All right, who you got in this matchup? Type DAL for the Dallas Cowboys. Type SF for the San Francisco 49ers. I think Dallas probably be a 5-6 point favorite. We'll see what shakes out. Should be a good matchup in Arlington, Texas. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel because we will have coverage throughout the NFL playoffs, news, rumors. We'll do some game previews as well. Probably do some watch parties here on our main channel also. Hit that big red button and subscribe today. We will continue to keep you guys up to date with all things NFL throughout the postseason. We'll do some playoff picture updates as well as we advance through these rounds, wild card divisional, conference championship weekend, and of course the Super Bowl. Subscribe. Don't miss out. All right, final wild card matchup in the NFC. Again, Green Bay has a bye this weekend. Arizona at LA, an NFC West battle. They split in the regular season. This will be interesting. When the NFL schedules this game, and B, who wins it? Arizona not trending that well, if we're being completely honest. I think, what'd they start? 7-8-0, and now they're 11-6. Not great. I'd probably favor LA pretty favorably in this matchup. But NFC West battle, both these teams know each other, right? Sean McVay and Cliff Kingsbury are buddies. So, I mean, these teams know each other very, very well. Should be an interesting matchup out west. Who you got in this one? You guys knew I was going to ask it. Type LAR for the Rams. Type ARI for the Arizona Cardinals in this NFC wildcard game. All right, so just a recap of the playoff picture. The Packers get the 1 seed. Bucks get the 2. They'll face the 7-seeded Eagles. Cowboys will face the 6-seeded 49ers as they are the 3-seed. And then the Rams and the Cardinals will face up in that 4-5 matchup. Real quickly, as we're filming this just moments before Sunday Night Football kicks off, AFC playoff picture. Titans clinch the number 1 seed. Chiefs clinch the number 2. Buffalo clinches the 3. Cincinnati's the 4-seed. 5-7 in flux depending on what happens between the Steelers and the Chargers. Pittsburgh will get in as the 7-seed, barring a tie tonight. There are a couple other scenarios as well at play depending on who wins, who loses. Here's all I know. Go to the Raiders Report right now. Type this into your browser, youtube.com/Raiders Report. Mitchell Rentz is live if you're watching this on Sunday night for Sunday Night Football. Do not miss it. Raiders Chargers on that channel. And here on our main channel, once that game is over, we'll have an AFC playoff picture as well. Appreciate you guys for tuning in. NFL playoffs, they're almost here, baby. Like the video, and we'll see you soon.